Good morning, and welcome to Rockville United Methodist online virtual service. Our service will be led today by Pastor Churl and features music selections by Karen Stearns. We hope you enjoy our worship today and take a moment at the end of the video to say hi in the comments section. Please check out the end of our video for RUMC announcements and contact information for the church. And please send announcements or prayer requests you'd like to share for future services to the church at rockvilleumc@outlook.com. Thank you, and now Pastor Churl.
Good morning, friends. Good to see you all, and thank you so much for joining our 62nd online service. And we are also celebrating our fifth in-person service on this Sunday morning. Finally, it's May, the perfect spring season. We love May because there are lots of family events we can celebrate together. Mother's Day, kids' graduation, and Memorial Day. Maybe on a wonderful sunny day, you just want to have a cookout in your backyard with your families and friends. Last year, we couldn't celebrate those family events because of the COVID-19. But I am sure this year, you will all gather together to celebrate those things as the vaccines has widespread in our communities. As the community of faith, we do plan to celebrate those family events in our gatherings. Next Sunday, May 9th, we will celebrate Mother's Day in our worship service. Our children will come and give the flowers to our grandmothers and mothers and sisters sitting in our pews. Please come and celebrate and honor our Mother's Day. I have another joyful announcement to all of you. During this beautiful season, we are going to have an outdoor service in our church memorial garden. We will start it from next Sunday, Mother's Day. I love this idea of having outdoor service because we will have a much safer service and we can enjoy the warm spring breeze and sunshine, and most of all, we can sing loudly all together. If the weather isn't great, of course we will go back inside and have a service in our sanctuary. Once again, friends, from next Sunday, May 9th, we'll be holding an outdoor service in our church memorial garden. Let us come together, enjoy this beautiful spring season, and worship God with joyful hearts as we sing together. Let us pray. Loving God, we praise and bless you for your mighty acts of creation in our world. As we gather together this day, help us realize that you are the Creator and Lord of all things, and we are your dear children. As we worship you, we may ask your presence and fill this place with the Holy Spirit so that we may be recharged and renewed. Come, Lord, and make us whole. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Eternal home, But for now, I walk this broken world. You walked it first. You know our pain, but you show hope can rise again up from the grave. Abide with me. Abide with me. Don't let me fall. And don't let go. Walk with me. And never leave. Ever close. God, abide with me. Gethsemane, before the cross, before the nails, overwhelmed, alone you prayed, your medicine, our suffering, and bore our shame. Abide with me, abide with me. Me fall and don't let go. Walk with me and never leave. Ever close, God abides me.
Hey kids, I'm so glad you're back for another children's message. So, I'm sure you've seen fruit grow on trees, probably have seen an apple tree before. But did you know that we are like fruit? Did you know that God considers what we do for Him to be fruit? That what we do for love for others is actually like sweet, delicious fruit. And that it brings life and joy to others. But the Bible says that Jesus wants us to bear even more fruit. He says that I am the true vine and you are the branches. And that's what Jesus says. So how do we stay fruitful? How do we bring good things for people to enjoy? Well, it's by staying close and connected to Jesus. So how do you do that? Well, there's a lot of ways to do that, but here's a couple. One is reading your Bible. Okay. Another is praying. Okay. And the last one that I'll give is being close to other believers. It's literally coming to church. Now I know in this time, it's hard, and it's hard to be safe. You know, we have this virus going on, but I encourage you guys to stay as connected with Jesus as you possibly can. You know, it says, apart from Jesus, we can't do anything. You say, well, wait, I ate breakfast this morning. I could do something. Well, the truth is that you have not given yourself even the breath that you breathe. You cannot give yourself anything. And the very fact that God is holding you and helping you do things is an act of love and God giving you life. But imagine if you spend even more time with the Lord, that you allow that branch to supply you the nutrition of God's Word. The Bible says that we don't live on bread alone, but also on every single word that proceeds out of the mouth of God, which, guess what? The Bible is what contains the words that God speaks to us. Okay? And prayer is so important to connect with God, to give thanks to God, to say, thank you, God, for all you give me. And, of course, spending time with other believers. So, maybe it's time to come back to church. Maybe it's time to say, ask your parents if you can make a phone call to a friend who also believes in Jesus. Well, guess what, kids? It's important to stay connected to Jesus, and I hope you do. And I'm going to try to stay connected to Jesus, and I pray that we all do the same. Have an awesome Sunday, kids. Bye.
Today's gospel lesson comes from John chapter 15, verses 1 through 18. I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. He removes every branch in me that bears no fruit. Every branch that bears fruit, he prunes to make it bear more fruit. You have already been cleansed by the word that I have spoken to you. Abide in me as I abide in you. Just as the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Those who abide in me and I in them bear much fruit, because apart from me you can do nothing. Whoever does not abide in me is thrown away like a branch and withers. Such branches are gathered, thrown into the fire, and burned. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, ask for whatever you wish, and it will be done for you. My Father is glorified by this, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God. Amen. Finally, it's May, the season that clothes the trees with the green leaves. In my neighborhood, I see some people ready mowing their yards and planting some flowers and seedlings in their gardens. Yes, it is the season when farmers and gardeners start sowing the seeds in the ground. To most people living in Connecticut, gardening is a part of their ordinary routines. Back in Jesus' day, growing grapes was a very popular farming in Israel. Grapes were the main fruit they enjoyed. Wine was never missing at all kinds of events in their lives. Most people in Israel are familiar with how to plant, grow, and prune the vine. So when Jesus says, I am the vine, he easily gained people's attention because they know all about the vine. In this parable, Jesus pictures himself as the main vine, and we are the branches. While meditating on this parable, some fundamental question came to my mind. That is, what does it mean to be a Christian? The answer also came from this parable. Simply put, Christians are the people who believe in Jesus as their Savior and practice his teachings in their daily lives. This parable of the vine and the branches is a perfect metaphor to describe our relationship with our Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus says, I am the true vine, and you are the branches. Those who abide in me, I in them, bear much fruit. Because apart from me, you can do nothing. This image is profound and yet very realistic in the sense that the vine and the branches must be connected to each other. Otherwise, the branches cannot bear any fruit. We need to know when Jesus gave this parable to his disciples. It was the night when he was arrested. Before he was arrested, Jesus was having his last supper with his disciples. And after the meal, he gave this parable to his disciples and moved to the mountain of Gethsemane to pray for the upcoming trial on a cross. At the moment of crisis, Jesus abided in his Father God and the Father in him. That is why he was bold enough to endure the sufferings on the cross. Jesus also knew that his disciples would be on trial later because of him. That is why he said in his last sermon, "I am the vine and abide in me." How can we stay strong and faithful even when our life is challenged by every kind of disaster? Here is Jesus' answer. "I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. If you abide in me, and my words abide in you, ask for whatever you wish, and it will be done for you." He knows what suffering is like. He knows what hardship is like. And he knows how to endure and overcome it as well. If we abide in Jesus and trust in his words, we will get through whatever circumstances we may be in. That is what Jesus tries to teach and promise to his disciples in his last sermon. A vine is made up of branches, and so we can say the branches are part of the vine. But the vine is not actually dependent on any branches or group of branches. It is the branches that are dependent on the vine. When the branches tightly cling to the vine, they can endure storms without withering or dying. Likewise, we can also endure all kinds of trials when we rely on our Lord Jesus Christ. The storm or trouble, whatever it is, nothing can cut off us because the vine, the Spirit of Jesus, will keep us to his living body. Yet, the branches are not supposed to be merely stuck to the vine. They have a special mission. When they are stuck to the vine, they are supposed to bear fruit. In his parable, Jesus continues to say, "Those who abide in me, I in them bear much fruit, because apart from me, you can do nothing." Then what kind of fruit? In a word, it is love. No one expects to have apples from the vine, right? Just like the vine bears grapes, we are supposed to bear the fruit of love because Jesus Christ we stick to is all about love. But before we talk about love in our ministry, we shouldn't miss the main point of this parable, which is our spiritual connection to Jesus Christ. Our Christian life first begins with abiding in Jesus, so we can receive his spiritual nourishment, and then we may be able to share or spread God's love in terms of mission to people living around us. In the beginning, I raised a fundamental question: what does it mean to be a Christian? Today's scripture teaches us that to be a Christian is to live united with God in Christ and express love in our lives for God and others. In terms of Jesus' parable, it is to abide in the love of God and to bear the love of God. During this Easter season, let us strengthen our faith in Christ, trust God's words and in entrust all things to our Lord Jesus Christ. so that our souls will faithfully abide in God and God in our lives. Let us also remember that Jesus is the true vine and we are his branches. So we will not depend on anything else but Jesus Christ, who is the source of our life, the source of our love, and source of our mission for the sake of God's glory. Thanks be to God. Amen. Time to share our joys and concerns. Friends, I have a joyful news to share with you this morning. Our sister Bridget Joy finally finished her long study and got her master's degree. Bridget, congratulations. We are so proud of you, admire you, and will continue to pray that God will bless you with your master's degree. Another joyful news comes from our sister, Karen. Well, whenever I see her these days, she's always smiling. Now I understand why. Her son, Matt, is now engaged to his girlfriend, Alice Frank. It is a joyful news. Let us keep Matt and Alice in our prayers that God will provide a wonderful life for those young couple. Well, here are concerns. I want to remind you that Our long friends John and Doreen Ward lost their beloved sister Mary Ann. We keep them in our prayers that God will touch their broken hearts. And also our longtime member Ray Nahodier is now struggling with brain cancer. It is stage 4, and I am even told that he didn't have much time to stay with us. We pray that God will provide a peaceful death along with his family, okay? Anything else? Please join me in silence. God, we worship you as the source of life. Grant that we always abide in your Son, Jesus Christ, the way, the truth, and the life towards you. And help us to be united with each other in your love and grace, so that we can evidence that the Christ our Lord is really risen and live with us and lead people to the way of your salvation. Lord, this morning, we gather together to lift up our joys and concerns, that you may listen to our voices, hear us, and bless our lives with your abundant love. We also want to lift up our friends and families whom you have placed in our hearts over the past weeks. We pray as we raise them up in our hearts and with the words of our lips. Lord, we are so proud of our sister Bridget Joy, who finished her long study and earned her master's degree. She showed us a good example of a perseverance of a life journey, and we expect you to bless her more and provide her with the path to a new life with her degree. Lord, we rejoice in joyful news from our sister Karen's son, Matt Stearns, for his engagement with his girlfriend, Alice Frank. You will keep them in your love and continue to bless them for their wonderful life together in your faith. Lord, we have a deep concern from our friends John and Doreen Ward, who lost their beloved daughter Mary Ann. We know you received her in your arms, that Mary Ann is no longer sick, but enjoy her eternal life with a perfect body and soul. But as the parents, they must be in deep sorrow. We ask you to keep them in your merciful arms and restore their spirit with your grace and love. Let them rely on you that they will stand strong in hope and joy and continue their life journey with us. We want to lift our friend Ray, who is now struggling with brain cancer. We are even told that he is now spending his last moment in this world. We ask you to provide him with a peaceful journey back to your kingdom, and also hold the family in your special mercy and compassion, that they will not lose their faith, but they can send their beloved in peace to your arms. Lord, we give you thanks that you have protected us from this pandemic and help us come together and bless us through our joyful gatherings in your house. Trusting your presence in our gatherings, we are inviting more people to our worship and ministry. As we plan to start our outdoor service and other joyful events in our gatherings, we ask you to be with us, guide us, help us always make a right decision of where to go and what to do for our safety. But oh Lord, wherever we are and whatever we do, help us serve you and worship you and pray for each other. We ask all these things in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Why you ever chose me has always been a mystery. All my life I've been told I belong at the end of the line with all the other not quite, with all the never get it right. But it turns out they're the looking for all this time. 'Cause I'm just a nobody, trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved my soul. Ever since you rescued me, you gave my heart a song to sing. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. When Moses had stage fright, and David brought a rock to a sword fight, you picked 12 outsiders nobody would have chosen, and you changed the world. Well, the moral of the story is everybody's got a purpose. So when I hear that devil start talking to me, saying, who do you think you are? I say, I'm just a nobody, trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved my soul. Ever since you rescued me, you gave my heart a song to sing. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus.
So let me go down, down, down in history as another blood-bought, faithful member of the family. And if they all forget my name, well, that's fine with me. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. So let me go down, down, down in history.
Go down in history.
As another blood-bought, faithful member of the family.
That's all I ever wanna be.
And if they all forget my name, well, that's fine with me. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus.
'Cause I'm just a nobody, trying to tell somebody who saved my soul. Ever since you rescued me, you gave my heart a song to sing. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus.
Jesus Christ is our vine, and we are his branches. Wherever we go and whatever we do, let us always rely on Jesus Christ, our vine, that we may be safe and strong enough to endure all kinds of storms of life, and even bear much fruit of the Holy Spirit. And our bearing fruit glorifies God, and it makes the world around us receive Jesus as the Lord and Savior. Go in peace. Amen.
Thank you again for joining us today for our service. Have a great week, and remember to please send your tithes and offerings and any announcements or prayer requests for next week's service to the church at rockvilleumc@outlook.com or call 860-875-6562. Have a great week, and remember to reach out to someone you love. Make a call, send a card, or send a text. All our very best. Amen.